you don't understand. You can't do trigonometry and correctly with correct getting the correct distances on the surface of a sphere with a spherical triangle. This is, it doesn't matter what way Google Earth try and portray it on the screen, they have to calculate it correctly, and the only way to calculate it correctly is through planar trigonometry. And that means planar trigonometry is giving us correct distances across all landmasses. And the reason it is because it's using 180 degrees within a triangle, because you can't do trigonometry with less or more than 180 degrees. It doesn't work. I'm trying to tell you, they can do trigonometry with more or less than 180 degrees. Are either crazy or liars.
Hello, I'm back again with yet another Brian's Flawed Logic video. And he's been very busy over the last week spreading misinformation, claiming that Google Earth uses flat Earth and flat maps for their distance calculations. I'm just going to critique his last video where he's created a right-angled spherical triangle in Google Earth, which spans the United States. For the first leg from New York to Seattle, Google returned a distance of 2,408 miles. The second leg from Seattle to somewhere near Los Alamos, California, gave him a distance of 906 miles. And after completing the last side of the triangle, Google gave a polygon distance of 5,867 miles, which meant that the hypotenuse leg has to be around 2,553 miles. So far, so good. Now, Brian has already said in his video that Google Earth distances are correct, despite the lines looking spherical, but he still feels the need to check the hypotenuse leg of the spherical triangle with an online right triangle calculator for planar triangles. And he goes on to revise the distance for the hypotenuse, adding 20 miles to it.
That gives me 2,573. So minus 2,552, and that one is 2,573. So I was out by a little bit because this is the triangle, right triangle calculator is more precise, obviously, right? It's calculated more correctly, right? So 2,573 miles. So that means that, what that means is, right, that this is all horizontal lines and horizontal distances.
So let me tell you what I've got going on here. I have 3 points and 3 sides forming a right-angled spherical triangle. The 3 sides are circular arcs, and Geogebra has no problem measuring them. And I've echoed those measurements up here. Point A in yellow is our right angle, and the side opposite that, also in yellow, is side A, which is the hypotenuse. Similarly, side B is opposite point B, and the same goes for C. Geogebra also has no problem measuring the angles at each point, and those are echoed here. If I click on the center point of the sphere, it resets to give us 390s. Down here we have the Pythagorean theorems for both planar and spherical right angle triangles. Both will output a value for the hypotenuse, but only one will match the actual measured value. What I'd like to do now is to recreate these 2 sides and let the hypotenuse create itself. Well, I think that's about it. It's as close as I'm going to get it. Let's check the winners and losers, shall we? Well, it's pretty clear to me that the spherical Pythagorean formula spat out Google Earth's value for the hypotenuse, and it was pretty much bang on too. The loser here is obviously Brian's logic, who just couldn't accept Google Earth's value of 2,552.82 miles. And instead, and out of desperation, Brian, in some hasty attempt to stick it to the opposition, went with this answer from the wrong formula.
Oh, that's gonna hurt.
And well done to all those in Brian's comment section who gave answers of 184 to 185 degrees for the angle sum. If you haven't seen it already, take a look at Andrew Johnston's response on his Eduardo channel. I'll leave a link to it in the description under other video responses. If you want to have a play with this geometry, I will leave a link for the script in the description below. If you enjoyed the video, hit the thumbs up and let me know what you think. Otherwise, thanks very much for watching, and I'll catch you later.